Jesus would refuse to be part of it, but he probably had a special place up there for whoever leaked a secret Citibank memo about their plan to rule the world. Back in 2005 and 6, Citigroup wrote three confidential memos to their wealthiest investors about how things were going. They reached the conclusion that the United States was no longer really a democracy, but had become a plutonomy, a society controlled exclusively by and for the benefit of the top 1% of the population, who now had more financial wealth than the bottom 95% combined. The memo gloated about the growing gap between rich and poor and how they were now the new aristocracy, and that there was no end in sight for the gravy train they were on. There was, though, one problem. According to Citigroup, the most potent and short-term threat would be society's demanding a more equitable share of the wealth. In other words, the peasants might revolt. Citigroup lamented that the non-rich might not have much economic power, but they do have equal voting power with the rich. One person, one vote. And that's what really scares them. That we can still vote. In fact, we have 99% of the votes, and they only have 1%. So why do the 99% put up with this? According to Citigroup, it's because the majority of the electorate believe that someday they will have a chance of becoming well-to-do themselves, if they just keep trying hard enough. The wealthy were pleased that so many people had bought into the American dream, while they, the rich, had no intention of ever sharing it with anyone.
I think capitalism is a lot more important than democracy. I'm not even a big believer in democracy. I always say that democracy can be two wolves and a sheep deciding on what to have for dinner.
This is Stephen Moore, no relation, a columnist and an editorial board member of the Wall Street Journal, the Daily Bible of corporate America.
Now, look, I'm in favor of people having the right to vote and things like that, but, you know, there are a lot of countries that have the right to vote that are still poor. Democracy doesn't always lead to a good economy or even a good political system. With capitalism, you are free to do what you want, to make whatever you want out of yourself. It doesn't mean you're going to succeed. Remember, the U.S. Constitution does not guarantee happiness.